Hello, in this video we'll show you how to make a steam distiller at home using a pressure cooker and a copper coil with ice or ice pack in the bucket. You can see right now I'm just testing right now this system, this boiling water inside this pressure cooker, and hot steam is coming and it is condensing in this bucket, and I'm collecting this cold water droplets in this glass. So we'll show you how to make this very easy system. We can utilize this to extract essential oils or any other oil from the herb. So let's start to make this one. It's very easy, very cheap, not much expensive. Hello, in this video I will show you how to make a condenser coil from the copper coil. So for that I have bought this 10 feet. You can see its specification over here. It's written 10 feet, 3 by 8 diameter. And so this is a copper coil, and it's a hollow. It's very easy to bend it. And I have this bucket, and I made a hole which is a 3 by 8. So first we'll make a coil, and for that I'm using this big jar to make a coil of this. So let's wrap this first. We need to make exactly with the same diameter of, basically you need to press it. You can easily hand press it to make a good coil. We need to just roll it around this box. So 3, 4, let's see how many rounds we can make it. So this is good, but let's give it some better shape once again. Bend it more. It should be like a spring shape. Now this is perfect. Okay, so we make a coil, condenser coil, and which can fit inside this bucket, you can see. But we may, and this hole is exactly fitting here, you can see. Yes, like this one, it is exactly 3.3 by 8. So we need some rubber gasket O-ring to make it fix it inside. And now I can expand a little bit so that we can. So you can adjust according to your how much you want. This would be good. And now we can make it straight a little bit. Like this. And then we'll connect plastic tube from here. And at the bottom we have to take it out, this tube from inside to out. So this is the way we can make a condenser coil for condensing the hot steam and oil. So now I have bent this tube at the bottom so that I can remove it from the hole like this. You can see it came out. And then I put inside a rubber stopper. You can see easily like this. So this will prevent the water come out. And if I need, I can add one more O-ring here in this container. So the coil is almost ready. Let's get a little bit more bent. And this side, I have this tubing, plastic rubber tube. I need to tie this again. And this is ready now as a condenser. So we can fill this bucket with the water and ice. We'll show you how to do that. And that would be ready as a condenser coil. Making just a little bit more good arrangement. So this is ready now. So I added a water rubber stopper outside and one is inside, you can see, to prevent any leak. And let's check if water is coming out. This is good, no leak. We can fill this bucket with water. So now this coil is ready, and condenser coil, we can pass our steam with the ice water inside the bucket and you can condense the liquid. Okay, so let's test this system if it is really working. So I put a Teflon tape at this joint so that no steam will come out, and then another tube of this rubber will go into pressure cooker lid. And then I will add a small amount of water in this pressure cooker. Right now I'm just testing if my system is working, and then close it. Let's switch the heating on, and then I will put water in this bucket. So there you can see I'm filling. So it's almost fill, and I'm using ice pack to cool this water, and now you can see there is no leak in this outlet, which is very good. So to cool this water, we can use either ice pack or ice, direct ice. I have some ice, so I can use these, which would be better to cool the water. So I'm just filling this bucket with ice, cold water, to make it water cold. And we'll see, once it will start boiling the water, see if steam will come from this nozzle and will go to into inlet, and it should cool inside the coil. Here we have, and this coil will cool the water, and the outlet we should get, rather than steam, condensed water. So we'll see once it will start boiling after some time. So now you can see this water is boiling here, and all the way the steam is going inside. And this area is very hot right now. It's very, very hot. And let's see what is going on here. And this is condensing. So water is condensing right now here, and it's coming down from this outlet. So this system is working, and we can use this for steam distillation. So this is the very simple way. You can see we are just making a very simple way of steam distiller at home using pressure cooker and the copper coil. And also you can reuse these ice pack once again. You can put it them in the freezer, and then they will be ready, so you need not to invest your in the purchasing ice or ice making. And here you can see this water is also condensing, so we can just move it to come it down, and at this end water is condensing very nicely. So basically right now this is a distilled water which can be used for any purpose, and this method we will use to distill, to make essential oils at home. It's coming very fast. You can see these droplets are coming very nicely. I hope you enjoy this video, and we will show you how to distill any other herb to extract the essential oil from that herb. Right now our system is working, and that is very good.